Item number, SCP-2137. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. When not being used, SCP-2137 is to be kept in a typical electronic 10-digit metal safe in the safe wing of Site-23. And if that's here, no wish to be sent for a wizard, there's no home to see what's best. Some may even say, no, it's a little law. Due to SCP-2137's anomalous effect having been determined to have no ranged limit, digital, wireless, and broadcast media may be used, but should be monitored closely for any appearance of SCP-2137-1 or 2. Once a week, 2137 is to be cleaned and all tracks are to be played in succession, with special attention played to the instance of 2137-1 that replaces track 7. The names, situations, and anecdotes presented in that instance of SCP-2137-1 must then be reported to 2137 Special Committee, PocWatch. On the rare occasion that non-Foundation organizations cannot address the issue presented in an instance of SCP-2137-1, O-59 is given authorization to activate MTF-339, the Shug Knights, to take any and all measures necessary to reach a resolution to the problem. Operational success will be indicated by a new instance of 2137-1. Personnel who wish to examine or attempt to interact with SCP-2137 must ask Dr. Kivowitz for authorization beforehand, which will then pend O-5 clearance. Description: SCP-2137 is a single compact disc copy of Me Against the World, a hip-hop album by the artist Tupac Shakur, released in 1995. Physical examination as well as laser testing indicates that the CD was one of the initial release, manufactured and distributed in 1995. Conventional testing of the disc itself reveals identical results to a non-anomalous copy of the album. The case and liner notes have been determined to have no anomalous qualities, and the physical makeup and encoding of the disc appear completely normal. However, upon playing track 7, normally heavy in the game, the listener will encounter an instance of SCP-2137-1. The anomaly takes the form of spontaneously generated, professionally produced songs featuring Tupac Shakur in various styles within the hip-hop genre. Though each instance of SCP-2137-1 generated is unique, they share certain commonalities in terms of subject matter. The central focus of the song invariably addresses a crime, almost always a murder or a series of murders, and then gives necessary anecdotal evidence or information to correctly identify and prosecute the killer, even going so far as to specify prosecutors or recommend vigilante justice. Though generation of SCP-2137-1 has been determined to have a definite causal nature, the manner in which SCP-2137-1 instances are copied onto SCP-2137 has yet to be ascertained. SCP-2137-2. The primary voice on the songs, from herein identified as SCP-2137-2, matches cleanly through advanced audio analysis to that of the real Tupac Shakur, who died in 1996, over a year before the recovery of SCP-2137. However, occasionally, on crimes of a particularly complicated or brutal nature, SCP-2137-2 will be joined by other performers, either guest rapping or singing the chorus or bridge. This is included in many of Tupac's contemporaries, such as Snoop Doggy Dogg, Nas, No Doubt, Everclear, Weezer, and Busta Rhymes, as well as artists from the 2000s including Chris Brown, Katy Perry, Lil Wayne, Lady Gaga, Rihanna, the Yang Yang Twins, Drake, Neon Trees, Jet, Jay-Z, Kanye West, and Eminem, usually at the height of their popularity. On a few notable occasions involving long unsolved crimes by still active criminals, there have been guests of a more blatantly anachronistic nature, standouts among whom include Phil Harris, the Andrews Sisters, Frank Sinatra, Buddy Holly, The Who, Elvis Presley, Diana Ross, and The Beatles. Heavily anachronistic guests tend to take the role of primary artist, the song performed in their style with SCP-2137 joining as a rap guest. When contacted, none of these artists had any recollection of recording for, or information regarding, SCP-2137. The crimes themselves share that they are unsolved or in some cases have escaped detection entirely. The majority of instances of SCP-2137-1 address crimes of private citizens, such as serial killers, spree killers, or career criminals, though occasionally the songs will address larger groups, such as Hamas, ISIS, the IRA, and even in two separate instances, the Chaos Insurgency and the Church of the Broken God. A prototypical example of SCP-2137-1 is included here for reference. Excerpt from SCP-2137-1-542. Jeff Reed out there and still stuck in the night, killed his brother of five strangers with the same damn knife. Now, it's not my place to tell you what to do, but I know what I would do if I were you. He hid the blade in the old barn off the North 111. He already got six, dog. Don't let him make it seven. When the crimes have been addressed and the guilty parties brought to life, either by the legal system or otherwise, SCP-2137-1 is immediately replaced by a new instance. However, the track is easily recorded through conventional means. Recorded versions are not subject to change or replacement, and the original can be replayed from the CD endlessly before the killer is found with little variation. There are currently nearly 1,000 instances of SCP-2137-2 on record. Initial recovery log. SCP-2137 was recovered in the home of Avon Lincoln, arrested for the vigilante slaying of Michael Ferris, who was later revealed to be the Ojai Strangler, responsible for six murders over the summer of 1996. Avon's insistence that Tupac Shakur spoke to him from beyond the grave and told him he had to take justice into his own hands because Ferris's position as district attorney would prevent a fair trial drew the attention of Foundation agents after the song in question was produced as evidence in court. Amnestics were administered to all involved and Lincoln was released back into the general population. Addendum 1A, the XK Incident. Initially, researchers experimented with anonymously tipping off local police departments through Foundation plants, which led to the resolution of over cold cases, including the recovery of SCP-and SCP-617, though no direct link has been established other than the murders involved. However, after years, this use of the SCP was deemed impractical. Repeatedly addressing the crimes discussed in 2137's music was, in practice, allowing the SCP to dictate the circumstances of its containment and, under the wrong circumstances, open the Foundation potential exposure through continuous interaction with law enforcement at all levels across multiple governments. In response to this, 059 ceased addressing the crimes in late 2000. After 2 months passed, SCP-2137's behavior radically changed when, for the first time, an instance of SCP-2137-1 was produced that revealed SCP-2137-2 had an awareness of its containment. Excerpt from SCP-2137-1-851. You say you're about security, but you ain't the good guys. You redacted expunge man, your silence is lies. You say you're here to protect it, you're letting killers run free. Don't make me show you how rough this thug can be. Well, you can't contain the king, dog. Homie, you don't want to start the struggle. I suggest you change the tune unless you're looking for trouble. Maybe y'all should lie back and let me do my duty, locked in a drawer feeling like y'all trying to screw me. You're stepping all up on my destiny. You might not believe I'm the real Pac, but I'm not just a CD. The decision was made to halt testing entirely rather than acquiesce. After 1 week passed, an instance of SCP-2137-1 appeared spontaneously on the YouTube channel of Los Angeles-based hip-hop station Data Expunged, and in the lone hour before it was taken down, accrued over views. XK Scenario Incident. The image displayed on the video was a still photograph, apparently authentic though by its nature highly anomalous. The photograph is of Shakur, estimated to be in his early 40s, wearing the garb of Foundation D-Class personnel, with his middle fingers raised. The accompanying song, titled focuses on SCP revealing its actual location and means by which it could be broken free of current containment procedures, and identified several members of the O5 Council by their first names as it described the function and nature of the Foundation. In a massive sweeping operation involving the activation of multiple task forces across continents, all trace of the video was erased and all viewers were administered Class A amnestics. Midway through this operation, an entire album titled XK Scenario was released to the iTunes account of Beyoncé Knowles. Each song featured SCP-2137-2 as well as a variety of guest artists, and focused on a different Keter-class SCP currently in captivity. Though SCP tracking bots were able to bring XK Scenario down after only downloads, complete digital eradication of the individual files has proven difficult. Though no loss of life or property has incurred, the sheer scale of the danger posed by this containment breach prompted a Foundation-wide state of high alert. This prompted an ongoing upgrade to all automatic SCP firewalls, and engendered the reclassification of SCP-2137 from Euclid to Keter. The breach sparked heated debate as to how to proceed with the containment of and conceptual understanding regarding SCP-2137, which came to an end upon the appearance of a new instance of SCP-2137-1. This instance was produced spontaneously through the mouth of SCP, which appeared to fall into a trance state during the incident, with the lyrics, in totality, repeatedly written in what was identified as data expunged 117,000 times all over the interior of its containment chamber. Excerpt from SCP-2137-1564. Help me catch my killers and I'll let you have yours. Trust me, you nerds do not want a war. What if I told you I it all? What if everyone knew that about to fall? You and the because I don't think you want playing in public. My nick. Montac. Make you my bitch. Fuck. And I see it all. You won't like what happens if you break the CD. Think my rhymes are a problem? You don't want to mess with the real me. I can hear you right thinking of a fucking plan. You can't stop me, I'm the fucking man. So consider long and hard the hammer I'm swinging, cause next time you open your mouth, it might just be me singing. The decision was made to resume the former method of testing, involving the embedded informants used to relay SCP-2137's evidence and information, while continuing to study the method by which SCP-2137 transmits its broadcasts, in an effort to truly contain it completely. SCP-2137-2 resumed its previous behavioral patterns, SCP-2137-1's focusing on crimes until their killers are located by conventional law enforcement, with the exception of one final track, at this time its last recorded direct interaction with the Foundation. Excerpt from SCP-2137-1565. Lil Wayne. Young Wizzle Wazzle Biggle Boggle Baby, I'm Anomalous. Got a room in Site 7 next to the talking hippopotamus. And you're forgiven, but now you gotta feed the meter. Young tune on the track, better upgrade this to Keter. Call me Mr. Magnanimous, Mr. Magnificent. Yeah, bitch, get like me, Wheezy F Baby, live for the SCP. SCP-2137-2. I knew you come around, step in the ring with a god and you're gonna get clowned. But let's be real, homie, there was no need to fight it. There's a grander design and I bet you're gonna like it. You got a lot of gray and that keeps you up at night, but sometimes things really are just black and white. Investigation into any kind of link or pattern between the crimes SCP-2137 solves is ongoing, as is interest as to why it doesn't use its agency to pursue the criminals in question rather than working through proxies.